For me, it's about the memories. It's a phrase I like to use a lot, regardless of the situation. And my five-year-old son, Eli, remembers everything. We'll be heading somewhere as a family, and suddenly out of the blue, Eli will ask, "Do you remember when?" And we never really know how to complete that phrase. It could be about something relevant to what's passing by his window at the time, or it could be something about what happened last year at the grocery store. I'm guessing the reason he remembers so much because his memories are built on 2099 days of existence. I, on the other hand, have a hard time remembering names even before they leave someone's lips. But I blame that on being around for 13,874 days. Even though I don't remember what I was doing 72 hours ago, there are some days that I'll never forget. These days can be categorized into two groups. Group one are family related, my priority, my wedding, birth of my two children, Eli, who's five, and Lily, who's eight. And if you want to see pictures of them, I can share them with you later. Camping in the backyard during winter. But group two will be related to teaching memories. I'll never forget how miserably horrible my first teaching interview went. I'll never forget Ian Dorco, a kindergarten student that I was student teaching with, who came up to me on the last day of school that I was there and said, "You know, Mr. Grover, there are a lot of things in this world that I hate, but the thing that I hate today is that you're leaving." I'll never forget the time that a mother hugged me and said, with tears in her eyes, "Thank you for what you did for my son."